in Stephen Chow's film Kung Fu Hustle, Tailor, Coolie, and Donut are Kung Fu masters hiding in the crowd. When fighting the Axe Gang, Tailor uses a technique called Iron Fist that employs iron rings in order to increase the strength and power of attacks and defensive moves. There's actually a southern style of kung fu that resembles the Iron Fist. It once terrified both pirates and the government alike. The style still exists in Zhujiajiao town in Shanghai. It is known as Southern Boat Boxing. It is a famous water town known for martial arts. Every Dragon Boat Festival, grand parades are held in Zhujiajiao. The most anticipated activity is the famous boat boxing. But, having been popular for centuries in southern China, the sport is gradually disappearing. Ding Yuchun is sad to see that only a few masters remain. Ding was born in Zhujiajiao in 1942. He's practiced boat boxing for over 40 years and is the only remaining master in Qingpu District. In 2011, just after his 70th birthday, Ding sold his house in downtown Shanghai to set up the Southern Martial Arts Academy in Zhujiajiao in order to teach boat boxing. He Lei has practiced martial arts since childhood and is a graduate of the Martial Arts Academy. Having studied boat boxing for over a year, he is Ding's first disciple in decades. Ding's planning to teach him everything he knows. Ding explains that boatmen practice boxing to keep fit and protect their boats. The special features of boat boxing can only be shown on board a boat. Ding asks a friend to find a fishing boat so he can perform. The Wu Dynasty Navy had compulsory boxing training for sailors. Their skill helped defeat General Cao Cao in one of the most important battles in Chinese history. After a period of war, defeated sailors settled along the Yangtze River and combined their skills with local techniques to create boat boxing. During the Ming and Qing dynasties, it developed to create these short and powerful movements.
哎呦，这显得真灵巧。那一，嗯，这这么一横灵活。哎，对，比较顶住了。哎，这个顶住是吧？这个这个负责比较多，还有叫马钉子，这个马步，这个钉起来，这个这个这个练的没错。哎，对对对，就用上了。这个梅花桩上的就腿功用到就船上去了。哦。啊，梅花桩是不动的，在梅花桩小，在船上修的大，在船上动，所以啊，这个到船上去打梅花桩，那这个难度更高了。
Pillars of Meihua plum style belongs to Shaolin Kung Fu. According to Zhujiajiao records, in the early Qing dynasty, a Shaolin monk escaped to Zhengjiadai village and was taken good care of by the villagers. He combined the pillars of Meihua plum style techniques with southern boat boxing and taught the villagers who used it on boats. This is how Zhujiajiao got its unique style of boat boxing.
Cool.
To better show the crew this style of martial arts, Ding puts 20 metal rings on his arms. He explains that this is an ancient weapon called iron wire that is strong both for offense and defense. With practice, it can help improve one's kung fu skills. Besides the boxing, He Lei has recently been learning to use a unique weapon called the buffalo horn spear. It was invented by Zhujiajiao boatmen and can only be found here.
你现在还玩的动这个吗？能动，但是动作用这个增兵器的话，那是动作要少多，要慢了。慢的多。现在你徒弟呢？徒弟也能，也不能像古代人一样，啥都这么快，是吧？啊，咋子的？哎，你好。好，你慢一点啊！这威风泼水，是吧？威风泼水是左右勾，左右左右那就像风一样的，来回来回勾，嗯嗯，啊，把手我左右的兵器从勾到旁边去了，再把你勾到身边，再把你推下去，把你跳起来，这个叫猛虎跳，猛牛跳虎。
The spear weighs 15 kilograms and He Lei tires quickly. He decides to change to a lighter version. Zhujiajiao's been the home of boat boxing for centuries, and it is the birthplace of the buffalo horn spear. How were these created and passed down? The town still hides many secrets. This is Zhujiajiao boat boxing. Zhujiajiao was formed during the Song and Ming dynasties. It is the doorway to the Grand Canal. People transporting cotton, rice, or oil had to pass through here. Because of this, Zhujiajiao quickly gained importance in the Yangtze River Delta trade. Businessmen from Jiangsu, Zhejiang, and Shanghai came here to ask for the price of rice. Up to 2 million kilograms could be traded in a single day. One can only imagine the scene of thousands of businessmen and ships.
出价角的米价没有定，然后上海的米价就看着我们，看一看出价角的米价出来多少钱一斤，然后他们再定下来上海出售多少钱一斤。因为什么是这样呢？因为粮食都是我们这里用过去的，如果我们今天三天不用粮，他们的米价就要涨了。啊，你看我们那个石头那个地方都有一个船鼻子，这个船鼻子就是几镇的。
By the Ming and Qing dynasties, the thriving water trade became the livelihood of many boatmen, as well as pirates. The pirates would attack anyone on the rivers with great ferocity. In the late Ming dynasty, they were everywhere. The authorities were paralyzed. So, boatmen began to train in boat boxing in order to defend themselves. Soon, this style of martial arts became very popular in Zhujiajiao and the surrounding villages, and everybody young and old trained in it. The popularity of Kung Fu in China quickly allowed many boxing groups to spring up. They refined the style to make it more practical and destructive, striking fear into the hearts of the pirates. They called it magic boxing. The style's been passed down for centuries in Zhujiajiao. Up until the 1960s, villagers around Zhujiajiao still practiced it. This was when Ding began to learn boxing from a master.
是我的师父叫李佳良，他的祖上呢是非常厉害的，也是一个武林高手，师兄有武林，我们这个大拳就是稍微的也几百个，其中有五六个高手都能劈钢叉，而且在表演的时候能把钢叉飞过放绳桥，这个钢叉沙啦啦啦沙啦啦一声音的，而且声浪滚，啊，滚的时候要抛起来，还能记住，不要去过桥了，现在女的站在那个地上。
There are over 30 bridges across the Saogeng River. The most famous is the Fengsheng Bridge, where Ding's master performed. More than 400 years ago, the abbot of Yuanjin Temple begged alms with his disciple. They built this five-arch bridge. It's the biggest in southern China.
这个江南五孔放绳桥的之所以这么大，它是横跨两翼。可以看到我们为什么要五孔呢？过往的船只太多了嘛，三孔的不够用，所以说它要五孔，也体现出明清两代它比较繁华。这里的漕河又是漕帮的发源地，它可以通太湖，又可以通京杭大运河，直接可以把粮食。 江南的大米通过船运送到北京。所以说，我们庙里的法师、觉明和姓朝两位老和尚、老前辈向社会募捐了13年，而且这个放生桥也修了13年。
During the Dragon Boat Festival parade, the bridge is packed with people who want to see the boat boxing. Zhujiajiao used to belong to Songjiang Prefecture and the opposite bank to Suzhou. Fengsheng Bridge provided a platform for boat boxing and helped to promote trade between the two prefectures. As business thrived, more ships filled the river and someone had to protect them. Boxing masters began providing escorts for the boats. It was common for the masters to test each other's skills.
有一次，这个他们村上来了一个，也是一个武林高手，拿了一个大斧子，他是用手啊把他凹对，每个人家，他是诚信来找你们这个村上有没有高手，其他人能马上去告诉姓何的一个爵士，他姓何的就知道了，他说你没什么东西哦。 我要当夫人，这个当夫人好不好？啊，你看好不好？我给你看一下。嗯，给他了。我讲的，他姓何的，拿到手里，啪，一用劲就变成粉了，变灰了。哎呦，他功夫这个不是一点点功夫啊，他这个手上能发射厉害多了。你把他给凹对，他把这个两个灰，哦哟，请教，请教，没哈，给把下风，他们就走了。
In times of war, boatmen not only protected themselves, but also the goods they transported, making weapons a necessity. But the big boat boxing organizations drew the mistrust of the Ming and Qing governments. In the early Qing dynasty, officials took strict precautions, forbidding people to hide metal weapons. So, the boatmen made spear-like weapons using water buffalo horns. Ding has trained kung fu for decades, and he collects old weapons that he keeps in a house in the town. Ding has spent over 10 years making the 18 weapons according to ancient references. Here, we learn about the real ancient spears. Ding says he was born here and began training martial arts at just 7 years old. That's 60 years ago now. He spent the last decades doing two things, training and earning money. This year he sold his company of 20 years so he could afford to buy the weapons chamber. He says that from now on he'll concentrate on doing what he enjoys most. Performances at river parades and real boat boxing. This is Zhujiajiao boat boxing. During the Ming and Qing dynasties, merchants would rest in Zhujiajiao as their cargo was transferred. The North Street has many tea shops and restaurants. There's also a dazzling variety of snacks. To attract the merchants, locals came up with all kinds of snacks to suit every taste. Along the old North Street, there are many old shops. Flagstone rows reveal the ancient style and show traces of the changing times. This post office, built in 1903, replaced the ancient relay stations and signified the end of the boat boxing escort agencies. The old town isn't the only choice for people here anymore. Many have new homes in the new district. In the future, the old town may be a mere memory, and boat boxing only a legend. Before the Dragon Boat Festival, the boatmen began to decorate their boats in preparation for the parade. Spear throwing and the buffalo horn spear are unique to boat boxing. Fengsheng Bridge is 9 meters tall and 5.8 meters wide. It's not easy to throw a spear across and catch it on the other side. Most people couldn't master the skill. In fact, it was so dangerous that it was banned in the 1940s. Even Ding has only heard about it from his master. Today's boat boxing show is performed by Ding's students in the hall. Ding is old and says that he won't perform in public anymore. Besides He Lei, Ding has dozens of young pupils. He says he might take some of them on as his apprentices. During the Qing Dynasty, grand performances were held during Buddhist festivals. Now, boxing is a tradition that's gradually becoming a form of entertainment only performed by small groups. Zhujiajiao is no longer a transportation hub. The use of boats has changed. But the town draws countless tourists from all over the world, ensuring its continued prosperity. Ding has realized that boat boxing, which prospered during the height of the area's water transport trade, is the inner spirit of the old town. Handing down boat boxing means protecting the town's heart.